हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे।
जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्री सभि गौर भक्त वृंद। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्री सभि गौर भक्त वृंद। हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीन बंधो जगतपते, गोपेश गोपी कांत राधा कांत नमोस्तुते। तप्त कंचन गौरंगी राधे वृंदानेश्वरी, वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिये। श्री राधे गुरु कानंद भगवान की
जय।
जय
हरे
कृष्णा भैया। हरे कृष्णा एवरीवन।
Right, nice to see everyone, and Hare Krishna, Soham.
Hare Krishna, everyone.
Hare Krishna, Ravi. All right. So, we started yesterday, Canto 3, right? That's the third book. And we are, of course, reading Chapter 1, Adhyay 1st, up to Shlok 13. So of course, there has been no quiz on Canto 2, right? We completed the whole book. There needs to be a quiz, right? So we'll have a quiz, but not today. Like exams, you have to give time to prepare, right? So this weekend is the time for preparation. What I suggest is, just go through only the texts. At least if you get a chance, there are only 10 chapters in Canto 2. Go through the texts of all 10 chapters if possible, and then be ready for the quiz. Yeah? So meanwhile, let's start Shlok 13. So this is about Vidur Maharaj, Vidur Mahatma, right? And the whole Canto 2 is basically describing this whole cosmos creation and how the cosmos creation is related to all different energies of the Lord. And then all the rishis get back and then say they really want to hear the devotional aspect. And when Mahatma Vidur talks to Maitreya Rishi, then it's a lot of devotional aspect and a lot of understanding about spiritual science. So we'll continue reading that. Anilji?
Sorry. एष दोषः पुरुष द्विडास्ते ग्रहान् प्रविष्टो यमपत्यमत्या पुष्णासि कृष्णादिमुखो गतश्री सिस्तजा श्वस्वैवं कुलकौशलाये। यू आर मेंटेनिंग ऑफेंस पर्सनिफाइड दुर्योधन एज योर इनफेलिबल सन, बट ही इज एनवियस ऑफ लॉर्ड कृष्णा. Because you are thus maintaining a non-devotee of Krishna, you are devoid of all auspicious qualities. Relieve yourself of this ill fortune as soon as possible and do good to the whole family. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. So who is saying this? Who is speaking right now?
Mahatma Vidur.
Mahatma Vidur, right?
Is Vidur Maharaj saying?
Right. Mahatma Vidur is saying. And to whom?
To King Dhritarashtra.
Right, Dhritarashtra Maharaj. So after Maharaj Dhritarashtra and Duryodhan, they denounced Lord Sri Krishna's proposal, Mahatma Vidur enters into Maharaj Dhritarashtra's chamber. And he is telling him that, hey, look, you are maintaining whom? Duryodhan, right? Who is envious of Lord Sri Krishna. So he's not a devotee of Lord Sri Krishna. And because he's not a devotee of Lord Sri Krishna, that is why you are not having all these auspicious qualities. So Mahatma Vidur is telling Maharaj Dhritarashtra that relieve yourself of this ill fortune as soon as possible. Once you do that, that will be good to the whole family. Yeah, kul koshalaya. So that'll be good for the whole family. And I think it is a nice purport. Let's read that. Soham.
A good son is called a patya, one who does not allow his father to fall down. The son can protect his father's soul. When the father is dead by offering sacrifices to please the Supreme Lord Vishnu, the system is still prevalent in India. After the death of his father, a son goes to offer sacrifices at the lotus feet of Vishnu at Gaya, and thus delivers the father's soul if the father has fallen. But if the son is already an enemy of Vishnu, inimical mood can be offered sacrifice unto Lord Vishnu's lotus feet? Lord Krishna is directly the personality of Godhead. Vishnu in Tridhana was inimical to him. He would therefore be unable to protect his father, Dhritarashtra. After his death, he himself was to fall down because of his faithlessness towards Vishnu. How then could he protect his father? Vidura advised Dhritarashtra to get rid of such an unworthy son as Duryodhana as soon as possible, if he was at all anxious to see the good of his family. Hare Krishna.
Krishna, thank you, Soham. And let's read this. Mayur.
According to the moral instructions of Chanakya Pandit, what is the use of a son who is neither a learned man nor a devotee of the Lord? If a son is not a devotee of the Supreme Lord, he is just like blind eyes, a source of trouble. A physician may sometimes advise the extrication of such useless eyes from their sockets so that one can be relieved of the Duryodhan was exactly like blind, troubling eyes. He would be a source of great trouble to the family of Dhritarashtra, as foreseen by Vidur. Vidur therefore rightly advised his eldest brother to get rid of this source of trouble. Dhritarashtra was wrongly maintaining such personified offense under the mistaken impression that Duryodhan was a good son able to liberate his father. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, right? So we all know the story of Mahabharata, of course.
इत्युचि वास्त्र सुयोधने धनेन प्रवृत्त पोप स्फूर्ति धारणेन असक्त कृतं स्प्रहेण यनशील क्षक्ता सकर्णा नुजसो बलेन. While speaking thus, Vidura, whose personal character was esteemed by the respectable person, was insulted by Duryodhan, who was swollen with anger and whose lips were trembling. Duryodhana was in the company with the Karna, his younger brother, and his maternal uncle, Shakuni. Hare Krishna.
And Duryodhana is standing there. He, of course, is not feeling great about all this. Tarun?
Ka in matro pa juhava jingha dasya suta yadu lineva pushta tasmin na prati pa प्रकृत्य आस्थे निर्वास्यता माशु पुराश्च वस्तानः. Who asked him to come here, this son of a kept mistress? is so crooked that he spies in the interest of the enemy against those on whose support he has grown up. Toss him out of the palace immediately and leave him with only his breath. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Right? So Duryodhana then says all these words for Mahatma Vidur. Hmm? Jinaji?
Mayam dhanurdwari nidhaya mayam bharto puro marmasu tadito api sa itthamatulle atyur varna karna banair gata vyatho ayadaru manayanaha. Thus being pierced by arrows through his ears and afflicted to the core of his heart, Vidur placed his bow on the door and quit his brother's palace. He was not sorry, for he considered the acts of the external energy to be supreme. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Yeah. So then Mahatma Vidur started towards the door to move out of that, right? Dhanurdwar, right? Like a burrow, like an arrow, right? So, you know, a couple of lines here, it says that a pure devotee of the Lord is never perturbed by an awkward position, right? Like, as we know, Mahatma Vidur was in such an awkward position that time. Because he's standing right there, the Charas Maharaj is there, and Duryodhana is just saying all these words, right? But they know, a pure devotee knows all this is created by the external energy of the Lord, right? So in Bhagavad Gita 3.27, also says, Prakateya Kriya Manani Gune Karmani Sarvasya Ahankara Vimuddhatma Kartamiti Manyate. Yeah, so like Soham, read this.
A conditioned soul absorbed in material existence under the influence of different modes of external energy, absorbed in the false ego, thinks that he is doing everything by himself. The external energy of the Lord, the material nature, is fully under the control of the Supreme Lord, and the conditioned soul is fully under the grip of external energy. Therefore, the conditioned soul is fully under the control of the law of the Lord, but due to illusion, he only thinks himself independent in his activities. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, right? So what essentially saying, right? Right? We say like every jobi karta, bhagwan karta. But then you have to feel that and you have to really know that that's actually true. Yeah? Nisha?
Sa nirgatah kaurav punya labdho gaja ayat tirtha padani anva kramat punya chikirsha yorvya adhishtito yani sahastra murtihi. By the pity, Vidura achieved the advantages of the pious Kauravas. After leaving Hastinapur, he took shelter of many places of pilgrimage, which are the Lord Lotus Feet. With a desire to gain a higher order of pious life, he traveled to holy places where thousands of transcendental forms of the Lord are situated. Hare Krishna.
Yeah, so Mahatma Vidur not only left Maharaj Dhritarashtra's place, but he actually left Hastinapur. Yeah, and so when he left Hastinapur, he went to many places of pilgrimage, right? And places like thousands of transcendental forms of the Lord are situated, right? Adhishtito yani sahasra murti hai. Right, of Lord Vishnu. So all these holy places he started visiting. And a very nice verse, but we are going to read the last paragraph here, Soham. Soham?
Oh, I was muted, sorry. In the land of Bharatavarsha, there are many hundreds of thousands of places of pilgrimage distributed all over the country, and by traditional practice, the common man visits such holy places during all seasons of the year. Some of the Arka representations of the Lord situated in different places of pilgrimage are mentioned here with the Lord is present at Mathura, the birthplace of Lord Krishna. As Adi Kesava, the Lord is present to birth Orissa as Lord Jagannatha, also known as Purusottama. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Mayur?
He is present at Allahabad, Prayag as Bindu Mahadev, Madhva. At Mandira Hill, he is present as Madhusadan. In the Anandarnya, he is known as Vasudev. Padmanabha and Janardana at Vishnukant. He is known as Vishnu, and at Mayapur, he is known as Hari. There are millions and billions of such archa forms of the Lord distributed all over the universe. All these archa murtis are summarized in the Chaitanya Charitamrita in the following words. Sarvatra prakashaha tandra bhakte sukhe dite jagatre adharma nase dharma stapite. The Lord has so distributed himself all over the universe just to give pleasure to the devotees, to give the common man facility to eradicate his sins and to establish religious principles in the world. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, right? So this is the most important aspect here, that we go to all these pilgrim places where the Lord himself is there in the Archmurti form, right? And it's said that it's almost as good as the Lord himself. And why is he there? So that, you know, the common man like us, you know, it's a facility to eradicate our sins and establish religious principles. Ajay?
Puresh Punyo Pavan Na Bhapand Kateshu Suritsar Su Anant Lingagay Samlang Kateshu Chachar Tirtha Yatne Vashnanyaha. He began to travel alone, thinking only of Krishna, through various holy places like Ayodhya, Dwarka, and Mathura. He traveled where the grove, hill, orchard, river, and lake are all pure and sinless, and where the forms of the unlimited decorate the temples. Thus, he performed the pilgrim's progress. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, right? So how Vidur is on the pilgrimage, basically, right? And, you know, it says that there is no difference between the potency of the arch and those of personal forms of the Lord, right? So all the arch mutis at all these places, right? There is no difference between the potencies of the Lord. And, you know, here Swami Prabhupada actually gives an example of the post box and the post office, right? Like wherever you post the letter, even if you post it on a mailbox, it will still get to the post office and it will still get to the right place. Okay. So same way, the arch form, you go and you see the darshan is like seeing the Krishna, and then ultimately be able to realize the Krishna. Yeah. Sachin?
Gam parya tanamedhya vivikta vritti sadapluto adha shayano avadhuda alakshita स्वैरव धूतवेशो व्रतानि चेरे हरितोषणानि. While so traversing the earth, he simply performed duties to please the Supreme Lord Hari. His occupation was pure and independent. He was constantly sanctified by taking his bath in holy places. Although he was in the dress of a mendicant and had no hair dressing nor a bed on which to lie, thus he was always unseen by his various relatives. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Right. So he was totally focused on pleasing Supreme Lord Hari. Vidur Mahatma, yeah? Veenaji?
Yeah. Ittam Vrajan Bharat Meva Varsham Kalen Yavad Pratvan Prabhasam Tavach Shasa Chit Mek Chakra Mek Mekat Patra Majitern Partha. Thus, when he was in the land of Bharatvarsh, traveling to all the places of pilgrimage, he visited Prabhasa Kshetra. At that time, Maharaj Yudhisthira was the emperor and held the world under one military strength and one flag. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Right? There was one flag for Maharaj Yudhisthira in the whole world. Yeah. And at that, so Vidur Mahatma, he reaches the place called Prabhas. Let's just read this, Soham.
More than 5,000 years ago, while Saint Vidura was traveling to Earth as a pilgrim, India was known as Bhatavasara, as it's known even today. The history of the world cannot give any symptomatic account for more than 3,000 years into the past, but before that the whole world was under the flag and military strength of Maharaj Yudhisthira, who was the emperor of the world. At present, there are hundreds of thousands of flags flapping the United Nations, but during the time of Vidura, there was, by the grace of Ajita, the Lord Krishna, only one flag. The nation of the world are very eager to again have one state under one flag. But how for this they must seek favor of Lord Krishna, who alone can help us become one worldwide nation. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Right. So what it says is you can go back before 3,000 years, right? And this we definitely know this is before 5,000 years. And in fact, there are all the geographical, if you are, you know, study geography and you know how the earth has moved and how those continents have been created, right? If somebody is interested in history, then you will see like the whole world was one and then all these continents was created, right? So we are getting some of those proofs right here. Anisha?
Tatrat Shushrav Shruhurthvinashtim Vanam Yatha Venuja Vayim Sanshrayam Sanspardhaya Dagda Mathanu Shochan Saraswatim Pratigyaya Pushunim. At the place of pilgrimage at Prabhas, it came to his knowledge that all his relatives had died due to violent passion, just as an entire forest burns due to fire produced by the friction of bamboos. After this, he proceeded west where the river Saraswati flows. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, right? So when Mahatma Vidura at Prabhas, he came to know about this whole war and all that, and then he proceeded west. So in the northwest, you know, where the Saraswati River flows. Saraswatim Pratyagyaya Tushnim. And there's a lot of history about the Saraswati River, actually, if you read. Anilji?
Tasyam tritasyosha naso manoscha prathor dhagner sati narisitasya vayo tirtham sudasasya gavam guhasya yachha dvadevasya cha asisheve. On the bank of the river Saraswati, there were 11 places of pilgrimage, namely Trita, Usana, Manu, Prathu, Agni, Asita, Vayu, Sudasa, Go, Guha, and Shraddha Deva. Vidura visited all of them and duly performed rituals. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, right? So like how Mahatma Vidura is on the pilgrimage. And then I think we are going to pause here. And then as Mahatma Vidur moves, he will meet Uddhav, right? Everyone knows Uddhav. And then he will meet, of course, Maitreya Rishi, and then we'll see the whole conversation. Let's pause here, since it's also Navratri. Yeah, and I think yesterday we had some internet issues, but we are going to play the Vaishnav Devi, live from Vaishnav Devi. I think yesterday it was live at Vaishnav Devi. So we are going to hear that for a few minutes. And then we'll see you tomorrow, right? Thursday. Any questions, comments? You good? Cool. So let's hear this directly from Vaishnav Devi. Yeah.
Namaste jagat vyapike vishwarupe Namaste jagavanda padaravinde Namaste jagat saranita hidurge Namaste jagat chintamana swarupe Namaste mahayogi vijnana rupe Namaste, namaste, sadhananda rupe, namaste, jagat tarini dahi durge, anadasya dinasya drishana durasya, vayatasya vedasya vadasya yanto, swamita gatir devi nirtar gatir, Namaste Jagattarini Nahi Durge Aranye Rane Narune Jatsu Madde Jane Sandade Rajage Prabhade Swamika Gatir Devi Nistare Dur Namaste Jagattarini Nahi Durge Apare Maha Sagare Vajja Dham Deha Vajja Swamika Gatir Devi Nistara Noka Namaste Jagattari Nindahi Durge Namaste Ndike Danda Thardanda Dena Samulpandita Ganda Rajesh Chatro Swamika Gatir Vigna Sando Harde Namaste Jagattarini Gahi Durge Swamika Satana Sita Satya Vade Anika Kila Kroda Nagroda Nisa Ida Pingala Sandra Sumana Chanadi Namaste Jagattarini Gahi Durge Namo Devi Durge Shive Vimanaje Sadhasarva Siddhe Pradhate Swarupe Vibhudhe Sadhambhala Ratrihe Swarupe Namaste Jagattarini Gahi Durge Sharanamasi